Now we discuss about the amplitude modulation. In the previous class, we have discussed about the modulation technique, modulation basics, isn't it? So in this class, I am going to explain about the amplitude modulation. First, we see the definition of amplitude modulation. It's nothing but the amplitude of the carrier wave is varied with respect to the instantaneous value of the modulating signal. See, this is the modulating signal and this is the carrier signal. This is the amplitude modulated signal, AM, output signal. See, this is sine representation, sine wave. So, the amplitude varies from plus Vm to minus Vm. And the carrier signal amplitude is represented by Vc. So, the amplitude varies from plus Vc to minus Vc. But the frequency is constant. Okay, the amplitude of the carrier is varied with respect to the modulating signal. See, the AM output signal, this is the amplitude of the carrier signal, because this is the new amplitude of the carrier signal, because this amplitude is varied with respect to the modulating signal. So this is the modulating signal and this is the carrier signal. So the amplitude of the carrier is varied with respect to the amplitude of the modulating signal. So here this is the maximum voltage V max and this is the minimum voltage V min. Maximum voltage varies from Vc to plus Vm. So this is the peak point. Okay, so this is the point. So in this point the maximum voltage is varies from Vc plus Vm. And this is the minimum voltage V min. This is nothing but the amplitude varies from Vc minus Vm. So this point, minimum point is here. So the minimum voltage varies from Vc minus Vm. Now we are going to discuss about the AM voltage distribution. Simply we are going to see the mathematical representation of AM. So this is the message signal M of T. So I am going to write the message signal equation. Let the message signal be V M of T is equal to, its amplitude is varies from plus Vm to minus Vm, isn't it? So V M of T is equal to, its corresponding amplitude is Vm. This is sine signal, sine. Frequency in terms of omega is, if frequency is omega form, omega m into t. So this is the message signal. Let the message signal be m of t is equal to vm into sine omega t. In the same way we are going to write the carrier signal equation. Carrier signal is C of T. So I am going to draw the carrier signal. So the amplitude varies from plus Vc to minus Vc. Amplitude of the carrier signal varies from plus Vc to minus Vc. So let the carrier signal Vc of T is equal to, carrier signal amplitude is Vc, this is sine, if frequency in terms of omega, omega Ct. So this is the carrier signal. So here let us draw the simple diagram AM modulator. So here it is, message signal. Which is represented by Vm of t is equal to Vm into sin omega mt, and this is carrier signal. Vc of t is equal to Vc into sin omega ct, and this is the Am modulated signal. Here we are getting Am modulated signal. Amplitude of the modulated wave is written as Vc plus Vm of t. Amplitude of the modulated wave is varied with respect to the modulating signal. So it is nothing but if Vc is commonly taken outside, then it will be 1 plus Vm by Vc sin omega mt. That is equal to Vc into 1 plus this Vm by Vc is nothing but denoted as m a sin omega mt. Therefore ma is equal to Vm by Vc. Ma is nothing but Vm by Vc. What is ma? It is modulation index or depth of modulation. So amplitude modulation, modulation index or depth of modulation is nothing but MA is equal to Vm by Vc. Then the instantaneous value of modulated signal can be written as, instantaneous value of the modulated signal can be written as Vam of t is equal to Vam into sin omega ct. We are having Vam value here in the third equation. We can substitute this Vc into 1 plus Ma into sin omega mt in the fifth equation. Okay, it's nothing, Vam is Vc into 1 plus Ma into sin omega mt and sin omega ct. Let us consider this equation as the sixth equation. So now we can expand this. What we are getting is Vc sin omega ct. We can expand this Vc sin omega ct. Then Vc sin omega ct, then plus ma into Vc sin omega ct into sin omega mt, isn't it? Then Vc sin omega ct ma Vc. So this is available in sin A sin B form. We know the equation for sin A sin B form. What is sin A sin B? It is nothing but sin A sin B is nothing but this is
sin omega ct sin omega mt sin a sin b is equal to cos a minus b minus cos a plus b divided by 2. So we can substitute this thing in the 7th equation. So we know that sin a sin b is equal to cos a minus b minus cos a plus b by 2. We are substituting this in the above 7th equation. So we will be getting vc sin omega ct plus ma vc by 2 cos omega c minus omega m into t minus cos omega c plus omega m into t. By expanding this equation, we will be getting vc sin 2 pi f ct because omega c we are having. So what is omega? It's nothing but 2 pi f. So we are substituting 2 pi f in omega c. So vc sin 2 pi f ct plus ma vc by 2 cos 2 pi of fc minus fm into t minus cos 2 pi of fc plus fm into t. So this is the final expression for the am voltage distribution. What is this? vc sin 2 pi f ct plus ma into vc by 2 cos 2 pi of fc minus fm into t minus cos 2 pi of fc plus fm into t. So this first term represents the, this is the carrier wave. First term represents the carrier wave and the second term represents the lower side band. This is lower side band fc minus fm, lower side band, and this is upper side band fc plus fm is upper side band t. So by seeing this expression, we are having three frequency component. One is carrier signal, this thing. First term represents the carrier signal, second term fc minus fm represents the lower side band, third term fc plus fm represents the upper side band. Then we draw the frequency spectrum of AM wave. Frequency spectrum is nothing but AM wave representation in frequency domain. It means that amplitude modulated wave is represented in frequency domain, then it is called as frequency spectrum. So we are taking frequency in x-axis. This is the amplitude of AM voltage, V AM of t. So this wave represents the carrier voltage. The corresponding frequency is carrier frequency fc. This is upper sideband frequency fc plus fm. Its corresponding amplitude is mavc by 2. Lower sideband is fc minus fm. Its corresponding amplitude is mavc by 2. So, in this expression we are having no first signal represents the carrier signal. Fc minus fm is lower sideband. Fc plus fm is upper sideband. And MAVC by 2 is nothing but the amplitude of the lower sideband and the upper sideband. Amplitude of sideband frequency is nothing but MAVC by 2. So here, FC plus FM is upper sideband, its corresponding amplitude is MAVC by 2. FC minus FM is nothing but lower sideband, its corresponding amplitude is MAVC by 2. So this is lower sideband and this is upper sideband. See, once again I am drawing the frequency spectrum. So the amplitude is VAM of T. So here I am taking frequency. I am drawing the carrier signal. Its voltage is VC. Its corresponding frequency is FC. Then I am drawing the upper sideband FC plus FM. Its corresponding amplitude is MA VC by 2. Then I am drawing the lower sideband FC minus FM. Its corresponding amplitude is MA VC by 2. So this is LSB, lower side band, and this is USB, upper side band. So now let us see the carrier signal.
carrier signal is nothing but VC of t is equal to VC sin omega CT. So this carrier signal does not contain any information, only it carries the signal. So the carrier signal contains more power. So most of the power is wasted. Most of the power is wasted during the transmission of the signal. Then one more thing, let us see the bandwidth of the AM. We know that bandwidth is nothing but the difference between the frequencies, upper frequency and the lower frequency. If we take the difference between upper frequency and the lower frequency, we can get the bandwidth. Bandwidth of AM is nothing but USB minus LSB. We know that USB is FC plus FM, LSB is FC minus FM. So if plus FC and minus FC get cancelled, so we'll be getting bandwidth is 2 FM or 2 omega M. So the bandwidth is higher, isn't it? Twice of the modulating frequency, 2 FM, twice of the modulating frequency is the bandwidth of modulated AM signal. So the AM output wave consists of twice of the bandwidth of the signal. So bandwidth is higher and power is higher in amplitude modulation. So this is the main drawback of amplitude modulation. First thing, most of the power is wasted in the carrier signal, because carrier signal does not contain any information, only it carries the signal. So the more amount of power is wasted in the carrier signal. And one more thing, the bandwidth is twice of the modulating frequency. So this is also higher than that of the message signal. So we can suppress the carrier signal with some modulation technique. A double sideband suppressed carrier and a single sideband suppressed carrier. What are all the things we should know for amplitude modulation? One is AM wave equation. The second one is modulation index. MA is equal to VM by VC is equal to EM by EC is equal to Vmax minus Vmin divided by Vmax plus Vmin. Then frequency spectrum. If the amplitude modulated wave is represented in frequency domain, then it is called as frequency spectrum. Then bandwidth. Bandwidth B is equal to twice of the modulating frequency.